recycled. That's how televangelist Apollo Chiboloi's lawyer described Senator Ontiveros' allegations against his client. Attorney Ferdinand Tupasso says cases against Chiboloi were filed in the Philippines, but they had since been dismissed. Tupasso also suspects politics is at play as House lawmakers investigate Chiboloi and his TV network, SMNI.
Ontiveros is fooling us. You know, the phrase in aid of legislation is not a magic wand that you wave around just to justify any investigation. You know, the expanded Anti-Human Trafficking Act was just passed last year, 2022. What has happened since then to justify another inquiry? This is plain and unadulterated baloney. As part of the feeding frenzy against Pastor Chiboloi, the SMNI, and the Kingdom of Jesus Christ.
But for UP Journalism Associate Professor Danilo Arau, analyzing the case of SMNI requires nuance. He believes it's time to review Congress's power to grant franchises to broadcasting stations and to reorganize a National Telecommunications Commission to protect its mandate from politics.
The difference between ABS-CBN and SMNI is that one is a press freedom issue and the other is not. Because when you talk about disinformation, when you talk about not verifying your sources of information and insisting that you are protected by the SHIELD law, when in fact you're engaging in disinformation, you are giving journalism a bad name. On one hand, I believe that SMNI deserves to be publicly chastised, publicly criticized for all the wrongs that are happening right now, including disinformation, especially red tagging. Number two, the power of Congress to grant legislative franchise for broadcast stations dates back to almost 100 years ago, and now it's time to rethink the rationale behind it, given the weaponization of laws.
An analyst believes it won't do the Philippines any good to declare Beijing's envoy to Manila as persona non grata. Retired Rear Admiral Romel Jude Ong from the Ateneo School of Government made the statement amid mounting calls to kick out Chinese Ambassador Wang Xilian. For Ong, this move won't address a problem concerning China's bullying in the West Philippine Sea.
But ang nakikita po rito, ang tanong po rito is, makakasolba ito sa problema natin or makakatulong ba ito in terms of addressing yung issues natin with China? Kung oo, then sige, maaari siguro gawin natin. Pero kung sa tingin natin, sa ating deliberation ay hindi naman siya makakatulong, I think medyo dapat pag-isipan pa yung ganung action.
The retired admiral also lauds the government's move to put international attention to Beijing's actions in the West Philippines.
Tama po yung direksyon ng posture ni President Marcos, yung ipahiwatig o paalam sa international community yung nangyayari dito sa South China Sea at sa West Philippine Sea. Kasi po ito yung isang strategiya na maaaring mag moderate ng behavior ng China. Kasi po, hindi lang naman po sa South China Sea ang engagement ng China.
Other news now, the Philippine Education Department says it has already accepted that it will not receive confidential funds next year. Our correspondent Joyce Balancho now on the line for more. Joyce?
Ron, the Department of Education, or DepEd, says it is no longer concerned that the bicameral conference committee decided to no longer reinstate its proposed confidential funds in the final version of the General Appropriations Bill, or GAB. DepEd Assistant Secretary Francis Bringas says that the department maintains its earlier statement during a Senate hearing that it can survive without confidential funds.
Hindi naman siya kawalan. So we have already accepted that during the last hearing that we had in Senate. That is why we proposed for its reallocation to a critical program of the department, particularly the National Learning Recovery Program.
Vice President Sara Duterte, who is also the concurrent DepEd Secretary, earlier requested confidential funds worth 500 million pesos for the office of the Vice President and 150 million pesos for DepEd for next year. She later announced that she will no longer pursue these funds since the issue had become divisive and instead requested that confidential funds for DepEd be realigned to the National Learning Recovery Program. Meanwhile, Ron, DepEd also says that it cannot promise to give the full 20,000 amount of Service Recognition Incentive, or SRI, for its teachers this year. Asik Gringas explains that the amount normally depends on the pooled savings of the department yearly. The department's budget officers and regional directors are said to need to find available funds that can be used as SRI. Last year, DepEd was only able to give out 15,000 pesos as SIR for all its employees. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Tuesday issued Administrative Order Number 12, which authorized the grant of a one-time SRI at a uniform rate not exceeding 20,000 pesos to all government employees for 2023. Ron?
Joyce Palancho with that report. Thanks, Joyce. President Marcos orders the creation of a task force that will consolidate measures for mitigating the impacts of the El Niño phenomenon. Marcos gave that directive during a sectoral meeting in the palace. He said a task force will be led by the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council under the office of the president. The government plans to assist five sectors in dealing with El Niño, namely the sectors of water, food, power, health, and public safety. A climate specialist says some 77% of the country may experience a dry spell or drought by May 2024 due to El Niño. Philippine power and water firms also gearing up to aid consumers ahead of the El Niño phenomenon. The country's largest power distributor, Meralco, expects a spike in demand during the hotter months of 2024. Based on initial forecasts, the Energy Department does not anticipate yellow or red alerts during the summer months, as additional power supplies are set to go online beforehand. Meanwhile, the Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System does not project a deficiency in water supply for Metro Manila and neighboring provinces. The State Weather Bureau is also urging consumers to be prudent in using water.